And now we are going to see something called populations. What is population? Okay. So, no organisms, they can be isolated, live in the particular world. Okay. So, any living entity, they are at least belongs to or they are depends on and the some other organisms. Okay. They cannot live alone. This is what you have to remember, something called the nature. Okay, so the population refers to over here a group of individuals, they are living in a particular habitat or particular environment or particular ecosystem, that is what called population. And now we are going to see what are all the population attributes we have to learn. Okay, what are all the terms related with the particular population, and then we are going to see some models of the population. Okay, how the particular population will grow and what are all the models we are going to see, the proposed models for the population growth. And as I told you, we are going to start with the population attributes. The terms we have to remember, something called the population attributes over here. Whenever we are talking about an individual, okay, we can say something called the birth and death. Okay, but while we are talking about a population, population, as I told you, is a group of individuals. It is not talking about a single individual or single person. Okay, so whenever we are talking about a population, we have to use the term called birth rate and death rate. Okay, we cannot say birth and death, because it is not talking about an individual or a single person. This is talking about a collective group. Okay, so we have to use the term birth rate and death rate. Both we have to use the term per capita, birth rate per capita and death rate per capita. That means in the particular area, in the during the particular given time, okay, how many birth has happened or how many death has happened. That is what talking about the birth rate and death rate. And sex ratio, this is another attribute we have to remember, something called in the population, sex ratio. Okay, again, this is not talking about an individual. As I told you, whatever may be the population, the sex ratio is talking about the ratio in between the presence of the male and female. Okay, this is roughly going to give the number or the ratio in between the male and female. For example, in a population, the male would be around 60% and the female would be around 40%. This is what called the sex ratio of a particular population. And while we are talking about the population, the male and the female, okay, we can go for some other factor or parameter called age. Okay, the age distribution. Okay, so if we can plot the particular age distribution, okay, the age distribution of the particular individuals in the population against the population density, we will get the age pyramid. Okay, so the age pyramid will roughly will give the idea of whether the particular population is growing or whether the particular population is declining or whether the particular population is in stable condition. Okay, the age pyramid, from the age pyramid we can get the rough idea of the particular population. And the other term we have to remember, we have to learn from the particular population, is called population density. Okay, so what do you mean by population density over here? The population density is roughly talking about the size of the particular population. Okay, so what may be whenever we are talking about the size, we are not supposed to use the term numbers. Okay, okay, population size. Okay, we cannot use the term the population numbers for the density of the population. As I told you, for example, in a petri plate, in a single petri plate, we can grow some trillions of bacteria, or we can grow some trillions of viruses. We cannot say the numbers. Okay, we cannot say some trillions of bacteria in the particular population. We can say the population density is the correct word, or population size is the better word for the particular density of a population. For example, a banyan tree, it can cover a huge volume of the particular space, but single tree, that is what you have to remember. Okay, so a single tree or single banyan tree, it can cover huge amount of or volume of surface. Okay, so the population number is not a correct term to explain the population density. Okay, we can say the density refers to the size of a particular population. Okay, and now we are going to discuss something called the population growth. So what do you mean by population growth? As I told you, a population refers to a collective or a collection of individual groups. Okay, over here, whenever there is a favorable environmental condition, what will happen? The population will reproduce themselves, and so that they are going to increase in their number. Okay, whenever there is a favorable condition, whenever there is enough food is available in the environment, whenever there is no unfavorable condition, when there is no predator in the environment, the particular group or the particular population will grow enormously. That is what called the population growth. But practically it is not going to happen. Okay, there should be no unfavorable condition, there should be no predators or parasite, or there should be no other harsh conditions from the environment. Okay, practically this is not possible. So we are going to learn some terms to understand the population growth. Okay, so what are all the factors they are going to determine the particular population growth? As I told you, natality, mortality, immigration and emigration, these are all the things they are going to determine the population growth or the population density in the particular environment. So what do you mean by natality? So natality refers to the number of birth at a given time, and the number of birth they're gonna add already, they're gonna add the some particular numbers already present in the particular population. Okay, that is what called natality. Okay, so what is natality? In a given population, the number of birth, they're gonna add the particular number of individuals to the particular population in a given time. That is what called natality. So what is mortality? Vice versa, the number of death at a given time, that is they are going to reduce the particular numbers from the given population. That is what called mortality. What is immigration and what is emigration? Immigration refers to the number of individuals moved into the particular population at a given time. Okay, number of individuals moved in at given time refers to immigration. Emigration refers to the number of individuals moved away from the particular populations in a given time. Okay, so all these factors, natality, mortality, immigration and emigration, all these factors, they're gonna affect the population density in a particular area. This is what you have to remember. So you can see it over here. This is what called the population density, the total number or size of the particular population. Okay, so the natality, they're going to increase the population density. The immigration, they're going to increase the population density. The mortality and the emigration, they're going to decrease the population density. This is what you have to remember something about the terms. Both natality and immigration, they can increase the population density or the population size, and both mortality and immigration, they can reduce the number of individuals in the population. So can they can reduce the population density of the particular area. Okay, and so we need some models to understand the particular population growth. As I told you, whenever there is a favorable condition, only favorable condition is available in the environment, what will happen? The particular individuals in the population, they're gonna reproduce themselves, they're gonna multiply in numbers, and they'll grow without any control. That is what gonna happen during the favorable condition. Okay, so we need some models to study the particular growth of the particular population. Okay, that is what we are going to see now, the growth models: exponential growth and logistic growth. Okay, so what do you mean by exponential growth? As I told you, only favorable condition is available. Okay, what will happen? Okay, we are going to plot the population density against the time. Okay, so from 0 point, the population start getting grow, only favorable condition is there. Okay, so what will happen against the time? Okay, it will start increasing, there is no problem in the environment. Okay, this is what called the exponential growth. Okay, there is no problem with the environment, the particular individuals in the population, they can multiply without any problem in the particular nature. And as I told you, practically this is not possible. Exponential growth of the particular population growth is practically not possible. What is possible? It is logistic growth. Okay, logistic growth refers to, there are some stages you should have studied in the previous classes. Okay, some growth curve model. Okay, we have studied some phases called lag phase, log phase, exponential phase, and death phase. Okay, so almost similar over here. Okay, over here in the logistic growth, we are gonna get the sigmoid curve. Okay, we are gonna get the curve like this, sigmoid curve. Okay, S shape or sigma shape curve we are gonna get. Okay, so S shape or sigma shape, why this is gonna happen? First, the lag phase, okay, it is gonna adapt to the particular environment, that is what called lag phase. Then after adaptation, it is gonna increase in the particular numbers called log phase. And after some period, the as I told you, the natality and the mortality rate will be almost equal, birth rate and death rate will be almost equal, and that is what called exponential phase. And after that phase, what will happen? As I told you, the death phase, it will lead to the death rate will be more than the birth rate. Okay, so that will give the logistic growth model of the particular population. Okay, that means the individuals in the population, they have to respond to the particular environment. In that way, they can reach only the logistic growth, they cannot reach the particular exponential growth. This is what you have to remember something about the population growth models. Okay, and these are all the points you have to remember something about the population. What are all the population attributes, and what do you mean by population growth, and what are all the factors they are going to determine the growth of a population. And then we have seen something called the models of the populations, and now we are going to move into the interactions between the organisms, how the individual organism, they are going to interact with the other organisms, what are all the possible ways and what are all the possible outcomes. That is what we are going to see now. As I told you in the previous section, no organism can be live in a isolated condition. Okay, so they have to interact in one way or other way in with the environment or with the other organism in the particular nature. Okay, so that is what we are going to see now, how the particular individuals in a population, they are going to interact with others. Okay, that is what we are going to call that as population interactions. Okay, so in this population interactions, the one organism, they may get benefit than the others, or both will get beneficial effect, or both will get negative effects. Okay, so there are so many interactions we are going to see, that is what we are going to see one by one. And see the particular table, species A and species B, individual 1 and individual 2. Okay, and there are some interaction ways we are going to see. As I told you, mutualism, competition, predation, parasitism, commensalism, and amensalism. So what do you mean by mutualism? Mutualism refers to both are getting beneficial effects because of the interaction between the two individuals. As I told you, for example, over here, species A and species B, they are going to be live together, and both getting beneficial effects by the interactions between them. Okay, the plus sign over here refers to they are getting beneficial effects from the particular interaction with each other. And over here, the competition, competition refers to in a particular place, and the species, they are going to fight for the common resources. Okay, so that is what called the competition. And over here you can see both are getting are affected by the particular interaction, the competition. And the predation, predation refers to the relationship between the predator and the prey. Okay, as we all know, the predator will get beneficial effect and the prey will get killed by or affected by the particular predator. And this relationship is called predation. And next relationship we are going to see the parasitism. Parasitism, as I told you, in the predation, over here the parasite, they are going to get beneficial effect from the host. Host, they are going to be affected or they are going to receive the harmful effect from the particular parasite. And commensalism, commensalism refers to one individual of the interaction, they are going to get beneficial effect, but there will be no harmful effect to the particular another individual in the particular interaction. That relationship is called commensalism. And amensalism, over here, one individual, they're gonna get the harmful effect, and there will be no positive or negative effect, that is neutral effect for the other species. These are all the interactions we have to remember, something called the population interactions. I'll repeat it: mutualism, competition, predation, parasitism, commensalism, and amensalism. Okay, and now we are going to see, as I told you, predation. So what is predation? The association should be very close. Okay, for example, the association or the interaction between the plants and the herbivores. Okay, we can call them as herbivores, but they are actually, they are gonna act as predator on plants. Okay, plants are their prey, and they are gonna eat the plants, then only they can survive. So this kind of relationship is called the predation. Okay, predator and prey. And competition, as I told you, the competition for common resources. This is what you have to remember. The competition may be in between the same species. The same species, they are competing for a common resource available in the environment. That is what a kind of competition. Sometimes the competition may be arise from different species. They are fighting for, or they are looking for a common resource in the particular area. And when we are discussing about something called the competition, we have to remember something called the competitive exclusion. That means this is we are getting the idea from the Darwinian works, the competitive exclusion. Competitively succeeded animals or the organisms, they can exclude the weak sectors from the particular area. That is what called the competitive exclusion. And next category interaction we are going to see, the parasitism. As I told you, the parasitism is the interaction between a parasite and host. Over here, the parasite, they are going to attach with, or they are going to interact with the host. In that way, they are going to suck, or they are going to suck everything from the particular host, and they are going to live on the host. That is what called the parasitism. There are kinds of parasitism: ectoparasites, endoparasite, brood parasitism. So what do you mean by ectoparasite? Ectoparasitism, ecto, outer. Okay, they are going to be parasitized in the surface of the particular host. That is what called the ectoparasitism. And endoparasites, they are going to be live within an animal body. They are going to live in the organs of the particular animal body. That is what called the endoparasites or the endoparasitism. And another category, this is interesting category, the brood parasitism. What do you mean by brood parasitism? There are some birds, okay, there are some birds, they are gonna lay their eggs into some other bird's nest. In that way, the second bird, they are gonna hatch the eggs of the first bird. This is what called brood parasitism. Okay, and the next interaction we are going to see, as I told you, the commensalism. Commensalism, as I told you, one individual or the in the interaction, one individual, they are going to get the beneficial effect, and the other individual, they won't have any harmful effect, or they are neutral. Okay, that is what called the commensalism. The example over here, the barnacles, they are going to attach with the whales, and they are going to eat the remainings of the whale's food. In that way, the barnacles, they are going to get beneficial, that is, they are going to get food from the whale remaining, but the whales, they won't have any harmful effect from the particular attachment of the particular barnacles. Fine. The final category we are going to see, the mutualism. Mutualism, as I told you, both the individuals in the particular interaction, they are going to get the beneficial effects from the particular interaction. That is what called the mutualism. For example, lichens. Lichens refers to the interaction in between a fungi and a photosynthetic bacteria, for example, cyanobacteria or the algae. Okay, this is what called lichens. Both are getting beneficial effects from the particular interaction. and the mycorrhiza again interaction between a fungi and roots of plants. Okay, over here again the fungi, they're gonna fix something for the minerals for the particular plants, and the plants, they're gonna provide food for the particular fungi. In that way they're gonna mutually beneficial, and this interaction is called mutualism. These are all the things we have to remember, something called remember about populations. Okay, as I told you, in the population we have to remember what is population, what are all the population attributes, and what are all the factors which gonna affect the population growth, and what are all the models of population. And then we have to remember something about the interactions of the population, in the individual interactions in the population, and what are all the examples belongs to the particular interaction. These are all the things we have to remember in the topic called the population. And now we are going to move to the next topic, that is what called ecosystem. Okay,